One of the things that I did notice as I was cleaning these up, let's see, can I just find us a couple of real extreme examples. And some of them will be extreme. This one is, well, it's not too bad. Let's see, oh, here's a bad one. Even, these are actually in pretty good shape. But I will show you something. When you are building these engines, and you take an engine apart, clean it all up to put it back together, and you, let's say you have this part that is worn out, and this one here is quite thin. That's worn really, really thin. They will wear out. This one right here is, you see how thin that is worn? See, that's really borderline on using that anymore. It could have a spacer put in there and set it back. Okay, almost right. But when you change parts around, and this part right here, it goes right here when you get it all assembled. It goes on this collar. And on the early models that didn't have the pin in the back of it here, on the housing, when it didn't have that pin, this hole in here, then this rotated, and this right here went around like that, and it would wear this housing here, and it would wear the backside of this. Okay, if you replace this with this one, which has no wear whatsoever, and you put this one on here, then you would actually, if you look at this thing right here, this high place here wore that, the other one worn into it. Oh, that's a good, oh, that's quite a bit. But you need to take a file, a grinder, and reshape that to where that it actually fits this collar. If you put it on like this right here, then all you're going to do is real quick to wear down this high place, and then it'll be out of adjustment. So that's the kind of things you set right when you're building the engine. The other thing, the two options are, and either one of these will work. This is the early one. You can replace it with the later one, or you can put this one with the later one and just not use that extra adjustment. Dimensions are the same. This brass example here was actually on an original engine. Now that this is a come from the factory original equipment, a brass shoe. There's some other documentation that I do know that this was original. The collars, this part here, the early ones did not have the brass collar that rotated in here. And the reason they put that collar in there is so that all of this mechanism could stay stationary, and the collar would stay stationary, and the other part would turn. And on the earlier model, this whole thing turned. It did not have that alignment pin there. And you will find them that these will be worn around to the extreme of like, most all of them will be egg-shaped at least. That one there, that's from here to there, that's a good half inch. That's like three, that's a half inch, let's say. But and it is wore there really bad. This one was on an engine, and that's rusted fast. I didn't take it apart. I wanted to show and tell, but you can see how much the rust has jacked that apart. As a matter of fact, it cracked it. So actually, rust cracked that housing. You can see it in there expanding. Collar that goes in here, there is a correct orientation for that collar. When you take it off, when you take this collar out, when you're assembling your engine, and you've got this two-piece collar set up here, and it is a matching set. If you turn it around this way, most of the time they won't line up. it's a match set. And this pin down here, that pin, if you assemble this unit, turn this brass thing around, it'll go like this. Okay, and you bolt it all together. Well, that would be correct in the rotation. And the reason that's important is this governor, that's where that governor fits, and that rides against that. If you don't have it, it digs into this part over here, and it'll bind up. So that does need to be correct. Another thing, just going to throw it in here really, really quick and pass on, because we will get to it a little bit later, is these brass screws right here. I do know the composition of these, and this brass here, you would say, oh, that's real good, let's put them brass screws in there. Well, that would be the worst thing you could do to this engine, is to put them brass screws in there. The next worser thing you could do is to put these stainless steels in there. Oh, they look good. I mean, you put them in there and tighten them up, they look really, really good with the washers and all. But just do not use this fancy metal, let's call it. We'll talk about that sometime on down the line. Secure yourself some bare metal bolts to go in there. And if you do have to use a bolt that does not have the screwdriver the screwdriver slot in it, just put it in the mill and mill yourself a square in there. Or when all else fails, just hacksaw it. You know, it's better to hacksaw a plain unplated bolt than it is to use a stainless steel. The another thing, let me show you something else. The inserts in these springs, see, this one don't have one in there, and right here they are. That's the little insert that's in that spring right there. And that's that screws up on there, and this is in that right there. And the thread on this insert is the same shape and thread count as this spring is here. So you do have to grind yourself a special bit to thread. If you're making these, and these is pretty easy to make. These things right here are really easy to make. Just grind yourself a tool bit that is the same half shape of this spring there inside, and then just thread it. Before you cut it off, thread the inside quarter 20. Left hand and right hand, don't forget that. Nothing much about these arms, except the flat place on them arms right there, is that's where that set screw would go. And when this works, it makes that thing work on that end up there. And we'll get a on engine shot at that. And one of the reasons that and you can see how many times that these old engines, some of the stories that they tell without no written history. It would be really hard to count how many times that screw has been put into different positions up there, all the way up to here past the little flat place there. So you have to question, you know, what was wrong with this engine that they had to move that thing, this dimension here? Why did they have to move it that many times? This one, oh yeah. It don't have one on it. I built this one. Several years ago, I built it a bunch of them. I didn't remember I had that, but I've not built a flat place in it yet. That's the reason that. And I will show you something else. This one right here, this arm right here, actually, I just dug these out of the corner over there too for a show and tell, but this was actually on the first International McCormick Deering that I ever purchased. This was actually on my first stem. And the reason that I have it off here in hand is I did build one out of brass. It has a complete brass arm on it. I was trying to find one. See, now this right here is the reason. See, all of those screw marks in there where they have moved this thing around that many times, and I don't understand that. How many times you could move it, but at some point in time they moved that back enough to where that was completely up to here. So, and looking at it, they have actually bent that right there. So, you know, you can actually read some. You know, it may have got damaged, you know, just in the shop there. This got bent, and instead of straightening that back, they just loosened that up and shot it back there and tied it up. But, you know, you kind of wonder at things like that. But, and I'm going to clean off the workbench, and we'll do some machine work and lay out a complete governor system.